हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज प्रोफेसर किशोर चंद्र रेवतकर फ्रॉम डॉक्टर अंबेडकर कॉलेज दीक्षा भूमि नागपुर। टुडे आई कम विथ स्मॉल टॉपिक और स्मॉल कंसेप्ट इन द वेव्स एंड ऑसिलेशंस, बिकॉज यू ऑलरेडी हैव वॉच माय प्रीवियस टू वीडियोस ऑन वेव्स एंड ऑसिलेशंस। सो दिस इज व्हाट आई से अ वेरी बेसिक एंड प्रिलिमिनरी वीडियो on the waves motion, what kind of the wave motions are there, what are the different properties are there, and that is very basic things I am discussing in this video. So now, what actually the wave or wave motion, we can say that. So if I drop a small stone or a pebble in the still water, as you can see in the first picture, then a kind of the circular waves, a disturbance in the waves that will be created, and then that will be up and down like of the thing, and then this wave which is being generated, which is moving away from the point where it has been created. So this is what we can call it as a waves or a motion in case of the liquid. Likewise, if I take a rope, then what will happen to this? A wave travels along its medium, but the individual particle just moves up and down. So I can show you in the animated picture also that here you can see when this rope is made to move in the upward and in the downward direction, a kind of the wave's motion that will be created. So the velocity of the rope or the particle that will be in this direction, in the upward direction, while in the direction of the propagation, you can see the velocity of the waves will be traveled. So the same example we can discuss over here. So we can take a rope, then a single wave pulse shows that it begins with the vibrations and transmitted through the internal force in the medium. Also, if you see here, when the rope will be given the jerk like this in the animated picture, you can see in the upward direction, the waves will be moving in the forward direction. So this are the particles which are in the upward direction and in the downward directions also, so that it can goes on slowly, slowly it can goes on progressing. So this is how the continuous wave starts with the vibrations too. And if the vibrations is simple harmonic motion, then the wave we can call it as a sinusoidal wave. So that is what the definition of the simple wave. These are some of the concepts which are associated, or some of the things that one should know. The first thing is the amplitude. Here you can see the maximum displacement of the particle from the mean position. If I consider this as a mean position, so here this particle or the rope is being attached to this particular body which is moving up and down, so having a to and fro motion. So here the maximum amplitude from here, still picture we can say, that is what we can call it as the amplitude. And the upper part or the positive side or upper side, we can say that it is the crest, and downward side where the same amplitude we do have is called as a trough in case of a wave, we can say that wave motion. And the distance between any two point, any two consecutive point, here that wavelength that is called as a lambda and denoted by wavelength. Here you can say that from this particular point or this, the maximum displacement from the crest or crest or any point, even if you consider here and here these two points, then they will give out a wavelength. Then frequency t and the period. How can I find out? A very simple definition of the frequency we can consider is the number of oscillations in a unit time. And my unit time may be a 1 second, my unit time may be a minute or an hour. That depends upon which unit I'm choosing. So frequency and time period, so they are inversely proportional. So from here we can find out the velocity, that is a product of the wavelength and the frequency. And this I am talking about the transverse wave. So there are two kind of the waves that we come across. One is called as a longitudinal wave and another one is called as a transverse wave. Here from the still picture you can see that. So there is a wave that will be moving, and here also you can see the same spring when that will be given a jerk. So that kind of the wave that is been moving, progressing in the direction which is perpendicular. Okay. So, and here a longitudinal wave, so there are two kind of the way, as I told you, the motion of the particle in a wave can either be perpendicular to the wave direction. So thus motion. So if I say this is the direction of the motion, this is the direction of the motion, because in this direction that will be progressing from left to the right, then the perpendicular, because here it is going in the upward and in the downward direction, so that kind of the wave is called as a transverse wave. Okay, and it is moving parallel to the direction of propagation. So if I say that this is my direction, okay, so this is my direction, then in this direction the waves is moving, so there is a compression and a refraction. Compression, particles coming close, particles going away. So likewise there is a motion. So the simple example of the transverse and the longitudinal wave we can give it. All the light waves, ordinary light waves you can consider. So light waves are a transverse waves, and the sound wave, the sound you are listening, any sound, that is what a longitudinal waves are here. So again in a more detail I can show it to you. So if I consider a drum and there is a membrane like that, and if there is an air column where here the compression like that, the piston that will be compressed. So then there is a compression and then the piston will be moving away. So in that case, in this particular part we have a rarefaction, and in this particular part we have a compression. So these waves are moving like that. Compression, rarefaction, compression, rarefaction. So that is in the direction of the propagation. And here the soldiers are lined up and they are producing a kind of the wave. So you can see here the wave will be going from the right hand here to the left hand, and then this kind of the wave that will be created. So this is what example of the transverse and the longitudinal wave. So one more thing, very interesting fact, let me share with you dear students, is that when the earthquake is produced, so then that earthquake is there, then it produces a transverse and longitudinal, both the waves. Both the type of the waves can travel through the material, because we know that from the center where the earthquake, that is called as epicenter, the waves are going away from that. So maybe a kilometers away they can go from the center where that has been created. So, but that means it can produce a waves which is perpendicular to the direction of the propagation and parallel to the direction of the propagation. So we can say that the transverse and the longitudinal wave, out of which the longitudinal waves can propagate through the fluid, that is why I have shown over here, fluid in the transverse direction. Keep in mind, only longitudinal wave can propagate through the fluid in the transverse direction, and fluid has no restoring force, because in case of a solid there is a restoring force, the back force that will be created, but not in case of the liquid. So here you can say that the surface wave, so I will come to here later on. So you can see here these kind of the waves that will be created over there because of this and that circular kind of the current that will be generated over there. And in case of the surface waves that travel along the boundary, so here we can have the surface, this duct will be going up and down as the waves are progressing. So in that case, or you can take a real time example, that when the surface waves are created, the tidal waves, so they will be there and they will be moving along the boundary. Okay, so now what about the energy that will be transported by the waves? How the energy can be transported? So that simple definition, we can say that the energy transported by the wave is directly proportional to the amplitude, that means the intensity. So intensity can be written as energy per time divided by area. So energy per unit of time divided by area, and energy per unit of time is called as a power. So power upon area. Or in terms of the intensity, if you want to see, then I is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. More is the amplitude, more will be the intensity of the light. Now, how the energy that will be transported in case of a spherical wave? Spherical wave means you just imagine a sphere, and at the center, so the wave that will be generated. So if a wave is able to spread out in a three-dimensionally from the source, and its medium is uniform, then that wave we can call it as a spherical wave. Okay, so just from the geometrical consideration, as long as the power output is constant, so we can say that I, that is the intensity, is inversely proportional to the square of radius of the spherical wave. So in case of a spherical wave, you can see it will be inversely proportional. So more is the radius, the less will be the intensity. So smaller is the radius of the sphere, okay, so then that intensity will be more. So now similarly, if we want to consider the energy that will be transported by a simple kind of the wave or transverse wave, we can say that. So then in case of a energy of a particle of a matter in the medium of the wave, then we can write down directly this energy is equal to 2 pi square rho s v into t. So v into t f square into a square. So f square, that is the frequency, and amplitude square, s is the displacement. From here we can find out the v into t, that will be the distance traveled by the waves in the medium. So assuming the entire medium has the same density, if we consider the density of the medium that will be same, then I is equal to power divided by s, and that can shows you because v and rho, that will be a constant quantity. So therefore I say that the intensity is proportional to the square of the frequency and square of the amplitude. Now there is a property of the waves, wave, that it can reflect and it can get transmitted. So wave reaching the end of its medium, so suppose we can have a medium and in which the wave that will be generated, and if it will be a dead end where the medium is still dead end, then in that case how the waves that will be going in the forward direction, and after that it will get reflected back. So that will be depending upon the two medium in which that will be moving. So if the medium is free to move, then it will get reflected back. So here also you can see this wave that will be going here, and if this medium is free, then this will end over here, and again the same wave that will be travel, as you can see from this animated picture, that it will be going back and it will be coming back, going back, going in the forward direction and coming back in the reverse direction. So that will be reflected, reflection, we can say that. So a wave hitting an obstacle will be reflected and its reflection will be inverted. This is what we can see. So when it will be going, and if it will be hitting the harder medium, so it will be changing. So the crest will be converted into trough, and trough will be converted into crest. So that will be depending upon what kind of the mediums are there, whether the wave is moving from the rare to the denser medium. Okay, so we can consider here also a wave encountering a denser medium. So here in this part we have a denser medium, we have a lighter medium. So here this thick line we consider as a denser medium, and a thin line we consider as a rarer medium. So then you can see this wave that will be generated here, it will be going in this direction, and in that case it can be changing. So from here it will be going back, and in the denser medium that waves will be moving with a in the denser medium, you if you can see the reflected and transmitted partly, if the wave speed is less in the denser medium, then the wavelength will be shorter. So here you can see the wavelength will be larger, and here you can see major, if you find, then the wavelength will be smaller over here. Similarly, if we consider a wave front, so what is a wave front? So that number of waves that will be moving. So if we can have a light point, light source, then transmitted waves are moving, or even we can consider the sound wave also, longitudinal waves, so then we can have this compression refraction. So in case of a two or three dimensional wave, can be represented by a wave front. So here we can say that these are the rays, okay, so which are the curves of the surface where the waves have the same phase. So here if you go, then the waves are moving. So here if I consider this line, then I can say that it is a compression, or this is a crest and then trough, and crest and trough like that. You can see minutely over here the waves are being generated. So there is a thick line and the light line, thick line and the light line. So here also you can see the alternate white and black lines are there. So these are this wave front where there is no phase difference, all the lines are moving with this. So that is called as a plane wave front, okay, And in this case, this is a spherical wave front where there is a phase difference that will be associated or aligned. So line perpendicular to these wave fronts are called as the rays, as it will be shown here. Also I had shown by a dotted line, and the wave fronts are called as the ray, and the point in the direction of propagation of the wave. So they are, these rays are being pointed in the direction, because these rays are moving from the source and they will be going away. Okay, so now this is probably a last slide. So reflection and transmission. So we can have a different kind of the wave fronts are there. So if we throw a light, and if I consider this is a surface, okay, this is a rear part of the surface, this is the front part, then this is a normal or perpendicular. So when we drop any light incident on that, making an angle of theta I, so I can call it this as angle between the incident ray and the normal, that is the angle of incidence. And when this light will get reflected, so this wave front will be reflected, as you can see from here, this is a incident wave front and this is a reflected wave front. So these lines are reflected lines and these four lines are the incident. Then this reflected ray, so there is definitely some angle will be there. So this is what I can say, theta I will be the angle of incidence and angle of reflection. So the laws of reflection, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. This is what you can say, that there are different kind of the laws, but we'll discuss those laws in another slides. Thank you very much. Thank you. If you like this video, please like it, share it. Thank you.